Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. First of all, let me thank the president himself. So I want to start with a personal reflection, jo thoda betakallufi aur shaistgi ke daire mein rehte hue betakallufi ka main izhar karunga. I have been a vocal and visible critic of the ruling party for many years. And around the same time, I believe the first call I made would have been in 2013, I reached out to all the key political leaders and all the key political parties to secure and seek their support for an issue that I was working on back then, which was education. And I wanted to share this anecdote because I think it's important and it speaks to why we sought the president's presence and requested him to grace the occasion by allowing us to be here at the Evanis Sadr for this event. Consistently and without fail, we found at that time Dr. Arif Alvi to be a tireless champion for education. There was never a moment when the Alif Elan team back then would reach out to a politician that we would ever find anyone more energized and more at the front of the line than Dr. Alvi. So, Mr. President, you have continued to do this despite you know, all the reasons in the world to not pick up when we called, and I think it speaks to your personal commitment to this country and to the issues that matter. So I warmly express my gratitude to you and my admiration for you for being driven by the issues. The issues in this country are not, I don't think they're a big secret, and I think one of the key drivers of change in this country is going to be the lower middle class and middle class children that grow up to become entrepreneurs that use technology. They don't use capital, they use technology to create capital. So we think that this is the absolutely single best opportunity for transformation in this country, and we think that there's a great reckoning that's happening right now as we see this piling up of startup investment and venture capital interest in this country, that this is exactly the right moment to leverage the interest of everybody that's here. It's a very small crowd, but that's not a mistake, or that's not an error, or that's not happenstance. It's a small crowd because champions for change are never, they're never a mob. It's a very select few that understand an opportunity that, that faces a country of 220 million people. I've been known to go on for a long time, so I'm gonna try and keep my remarks limited. And I just want to share, you know, kind of what is the potential. And again, we've heard all of these things before, but it's important to repeat them and repeat them over and over and over again. The beginnings of this investment that we see, the energy that we see in the tech sector, is on the basis purely of the population and demographic potential of this country. So we've barely gotten on the plane, what to say, of getting on the runway and taking off. And even then, we see hundreds of millions of dollars pouring into Pakistan. At the same time as a massive security challenge to the north of us in this neighborhood, at the same time as a global imports and commodities price hike, at the same time as an oil price hike, an LNG price hike, we are still every day, every other day, every week, we see news of a new startup getting this money. What is that telling us? It's telling us that the potential of Pakistan is so high that all of the problems of Pakistan don't matter, and that that potential is worth the interest of investors. What do we need to do? We need to make sure that the direction of these investments and the hope and promise of the people of Pakistan is met with a policy architecture that leans into it. And I'm really, really delighted to see Ahmed Hashmi here, the chairperson of the STZA. I think the existence of the Special Technology Zones Authority is one great sign of this country's recognition of this opportunity. But a lot more needs to happen. I'm not gonna go into what needs to happen because thankfully we had real experts, Ali Khizr, Hamad Haider, Umar Nadeem, and Aliza Amin, work on this document and prepare a long list of things that need to happen, both in the short term and in the long term. So inshallah, I hope that all of you will have a chance to read the document. This is the second major document that we've published under the banner of the Center for Digital Transformation. Inshallah, we will continue to push hard on serious policy inputs into the system, and we'll keep expecting all of you that are here, and to whom I'm immensely grateful for your interest, your support, your endorsement, and your participation in conversations like this. I also just do want to make note of the presence of my parents here. It's always a great moment for a son to have his parents be in this kind of a setting. So thanks, Mom and Dad, for everything. Thank you again to His Excellency, the President of Pakistan, who has once again endorsed through his actions and words his own personal commitment to the things that really matter. And to everyone else, I'm grateful. I'm sure all of you will read the report in great detail. Even if you think it's boring, I would beg that you do, because I think the more people that read this and get interested in this, the more the research of friends like Ali Khizr and Hamad and Aliza and Umar will matter. I didn't want to end without thanking the Tabad Lab team, who worked tirelessly and who's a very, it's a very young group of people. So I don't want to name everyone, but in particular, Bisma, Zain, Same, the whole team that worked on this. Of course, Ambar, thanks to those folks as well. That's it from me. Thank you.